URL certified.
I can find a nigga on a corner right now that's out rapping you. I promise you, New York just New York breed them. New York breed them.
I don't even rap like that. I never had a job at JCPenney's. I never rap gifts. I don't do snack wraps from McDonald's, nigga. Like I've never been on that type of time.
Let me ask you a question, Kev.
Yeah.
We see this whole thing going on with fucking the Drake Kendrick or can we even say Cole anymore?
Yeah, I think we got to rest in peace Cole's name.
Cole out of there, Cole out.
He's out of here, y'all. And this whole thing, man, I'm hearing from the lips of Joe Budden himself. He said that prepare for nuclear bombs from Drake and Kendrick.
Yeah.
I'm interested to see what's going on. But anyway, let's get into the show, y'all. We are back, man. It's been a couple of months, but All Jokes Aside podcast is back, guys, in case you haven't been under a rock. This is the brand new All Jokes Aside TV and Media Studios. Y'all going to see a lot of new shit out of this show. First and foremost, let me introduce my brand new co-host of the show, the great Kevin Deane, comedian Kevin. I don't like to say comedian. I think that's, we both comedians, but when you put the comedian title in front of your name.
Yeah. Just let the people know who I am. Comedian Kevin Deane, a.k.a. Mr. 407 Kevin. You know, one of the nastiest niggas to do it out here in Orlando.
Yeah, he's definitely doing his thing out here in these streets.
Yes, sir. Fresh Prince of Kissimmee, Lando Calrissian, you know, whatever.
Lando Calrissian. Or, I like that.
Orlando Calrissian.
Orlando Calrissian. That's nasty.
Yeah.
You fuck with Star Wars?
Yeah, all day.
You know what? That's a dumb ass question.
Yeah, I'm on all the type of nerd shit. I'm hitting all the nerd chicks in all the forums.
You know, that's not a bad, you know, I like nerdy chicks.
Bro, I like chicks. I like girls.
You know what's the misconception about nerds?
Huh?
Is that they're smart.
No. Geeks are smart.
Right. Nerds are dumb.
Yeah.
Nerds are into toys and anime. Them niggas don't be smart, son. Niggas be stupid, son.
I look at it like a Venn diagram. There's nerds and there's geeks, and then there's the ones in the middle. There are nerds that can be smart.
Right.
But that's not the default.
Right.
Yeah. Like, there's dorks and geeks, and in the middle, there's nerds.
Right. Okay. So we're going to get into the show, because we got a lot to unpack today. Pause. No diddy, son. No diddy.
Is unpack pause worthy now?
Niggas unpack is crazy.
Niggas
son.
Can't have a suitcase. No, we got a lot.
We got because there's three men here. I said we got a lot to unpack. That sound kind of crazy.
I feel like y'all are searching for pause worthy moments where there's not none. I'm just putting my clothes away. I'm taking my suit out of the suitcase.
We can get it to listen. And we had a guest, a special guest today. It was David Jolly, who I'll be performing with tonight at the Orlando Funny Bone, mm-hmm. which I hate saying. The improv sounds so much better. He's in town. It's a welcome home show tonight. I'm going to be going in to perform with him tonight. And his bitch ass was supposed to be here today, but he didn't show up.
Mm.
All right, so we put a nigga on blast.
Acting Hollywood.
Yeah, acting Hollywood and shit out there on Kill Tony in Austin, Texas. But we'll get him the next time. And his stay, we have the better half of me. This is my son. You guys saw him. I'm gonna put that clip up. I think he was on the podcast maybe about 4 years ago. Yeah, had to be about yeah, 4 years yeah, ago.
Vicky,
yeah, like
word.
4 years ago he was on the show. And that was like episode probably 40.
Yeah, that was a minute.
Yeah, it was like 4 years ago he was on the show.
Okay.
And he's permanently here now in the state of Florida now. He's moved down.
Let's go.
From New York.
Yeah, let's go.
So we're gonna have him sit in. For Jolly, and y'all gonna see him a bunch because he's here. All right, so let's get right into the show, y'all. Let's get back into what we're talking about. It's probably been talked about enough, but nobody heard. I did a video on it on J. Cole. Did you see my video?
Yes.
It did some numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And I stick by what I said. The niggas, you know what? You.
Yes.
What was your opinion on that?
Is my opinion on the apology or the verse that he dropped? Because that's two different opinions.
The verse is null and void now after right. the apology.
Yeah.
So I don't even want to hear about the verse.
The verse is buried. He didn't believe it when he said the verse. I like the verse.
I did too.
I thought it was a good soft punch.
I did too.
Punch.
I thought it was cool.
I thought it was a good soft punch. It was like an introduction, like, hey, we doing this. We sparring a little bit.
I
thought it
was
cool.
But I was waiting for round two. What'd you say?
I was waiting for round two.
The one thing I didn't like was the fact that he tried to make it like it was like a jab.
Yeah.
And it really wasn't. That's that, when he said it was a, what's the word he said? He said that was a warning shot.
Yeah.
I'm like, nigga, no, that's not. That's what you got.
Yeah, it's everything you got.
That's all you got right now at the moment. Nigga, stop capping. That's all you got. You're waiting for him to respond. Then you'll have more ammo.
You're gonna rebuttal, yeah.
Yeah, you don't have enough ammo. So, yeah, I don't believe that when he said that that was a warning shot. That's bullshit. What was your take on it? The verse. We can get a little too about the verse.
The verse? I thought the verse was cool. I didn't think that was all that he had. I thought that he had more. I thought he could have gave out more. But for round one, I thought that was cool. I was waiting for round two.
Right, because these are two
giants.
Probably two giants in the game. So even in boxing, it's respect.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't give. It probably was. Yeah, you fill them out a little bit in the first round. Yeah. So yeah, I agree with that.
I don't know a lot about boxing, but I know about Dragon Ball Z. Goku don't ever go Super Saiyan right away.
That's a fact.
He gonna always play with his opponent first.
That's a fact.
And feel what they doing. Pause before.
Yeah, you don't go Super Saiyan in the first round.
Right. You definitely don't go all the way Super Saiyan. You don't go Super Saiyan God or whatever the levels are to this.
But I think rap is different. No. You know what? If it's a battle, then it's a limited amount of things you can say.
I think that Cole acted like he had so much in the tuck, but it seemed like, hey.
Yeah.
To call a song 7-minute drill, and I understand it's a military reference, but have it only be 3 minutes.
That was crazy.
Yeah. You don't have the time. You don't have the material. You don't have the commentary. I think that you ran out of juice and was like, this is everything. Hopefully he won't say nothing back to me. Or like you said, I got to just go off of the rebuttals.
Right. Because that's where you come with. You got to rebuttal off the shit he say about you to defend yourself. Because J. Cole is very defensive.
Right. And Kendrick is a recluse. So like, we don't know a lot about Kendrick. I don't have a lot of material. You don't have some secret baby mom somewhere. I didn't catch you doing no gay shit in 09. Like,
right. And he B-rabbits himself a lot.
Right.
Right. I'm going to say everything. I already said what you're going to say about me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I told you I don't like no fly shit. I told you this. So that's not even an insult to diss a nigga who owning the bullshit. You know what I'm saying? So
my problem is the internet. There's so many different sides of the internet, and there's the Cole stands, there's the Kendrick stands, there's all these different people. I think that Cole spoke for a lot of people that were too scared to say it. Like, he was like, yo, To Pimp a Butterfly was a little overhyped. They gassed it.
Do you think it was overhyped?
I don't think that everybody thinks that. I think that there's a fan base that loves that album.
Right.
I feel like he was speaking for a nigga like me personally. There's some niggas that are like, yo, I respect Good Kid, Mad City. I respect Damn.
Right.
But this Big Steppers and To
Pimp a Butterfly. Yeah, that was the album I wasn't really fucking with.
Yeah, and a lot of people.
That shit was mid, son.
A lot of people are not going
to
say that.
I didn't really listen to it.
That last joint, that was it, the Big Stepper and the Little Stepper? What the fuck was it called?
That shit came and went.
I wasn't really fucking with that album.
It had
no replay value, bro.
But Kendrick is such a star, and he's so big, and he's in the big three that we kind of just like. Didn't say nothing about it. We didn't say nothing positive or negative. I didn't see nobody killing him for that album.
Right. It wasn't whack. It just was like, come on, son. How you going to give me that and then give me this?
Right. And so Cole.
And then don't give me nothing else after that.
And you go disappear for like 4 or 5 years. Yeah. That's weird.
Yeah.
So Cole, I think that Cole gave a mouthpiece.
He Frank Ocean us.
Yeah. A lot of these dudes who we give the, we're prisoners of the moment. We give all of these people title of genius or like, yo, this guy is changing the game.
Yeah, these niggas ain't geniuses, son.
Right. And we all got a great freshman debut. And then they come out and Blonde is an amazing album.
100%. But that's not his freshman.
No. I know.
Blonde
Channel,
was good.
Channel Orange.
Yeah.
Channel Orange was amazing.
Well, he had shit before that. He had the Lonnie Bro. Lonnie Bro was, but that was like an underground. Then he had Nostalgia.
Okay, see, you're schooling me. I'm talking about like debut albums or like
Channel Orange was the debut
commercial album,
but he had shit that was in the tuck. Remember, he come from All Future camp, so his album Gets Cali. He got albums that you can't even find nowhere.
Right,
you got to go on YouTube to find Frank Ocean shit, bro.
Yeah, so I don't have the information about that, and I'm never delving that deep on a nigga who sucks dick. So. Apologies, Frank. I love your music.
I gotta find my fucking soundboard. But but
Pyramids is my shit,
bro. That's the concept of that song is crazy, son.
Yeah, that might be like one of the greatest conceptual songs of all,
bro. Facts, because and it's also rings true. Like you know Pyramids, Frank Ocean. All right, so the concept of the song is in the beginning, it was a girl named Cleopatra living in the pyramid because she was a queen. Mm. Then in the second half of the song, it's Cleopatra who works in a strip club called The Pyramid.
Yeah.
And instead of being a, she's a stripper now.
Mm.
And I'm like, damn, this. And bro, he's like 21 doing that.
Yeah. Now, so a lot of people will see that and gas it and be like, yo, this dude is the Messiah. He's the next dude coming. And Kendrick earns the title, to get back to what we're talking about.
Right.
Kendrick deserves all of the praise that he has. He's got a Pulitzer, for Christ's sakes. Right. But I think that we don't allow people who have those type of prizes and accolades to face criticism. We don't criticize them the same.
You think they... My only criticism of his is I don't know if he drank his own Kool-Aid. I think in order to come up with that level of material, you have to take a mental break.
Yeah.
Because it could drive you mad. And listen, I'm not saying I'm the best comic in the world, but my material that I drop online, if you notice, I haven't really dropped no videos in a while. Bro, I literally got writer's block, bro.
Yeah, no, I've been there before. I same thing.
You go viral, so you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. Like, bro, it's hard. People think you just jump on here screaming. It's like, nigga, it's a level of thought. It's thought behind this shit. It's not like I'm not just getting up here saying random shit. Like, I thought about this shit, bro.
And you also have, you don't have the luxury of having to compete with your last work. A lot of people don't understand that. Like,
you always competed with your last word.
Yeah, nigga who don't have no viral moments, don't have no like big videos, he can just put anything out because anything that does well is gonna look good. Right. But if I put something out and it does 2,000 likes, 2,500 likes, but the last video did 500,000, they're gonna look at me like I'm falling off, like I'm slipping. So I'm constantly in my head like, yo, the next thing that I drop needs to be just as good as the last, if not better.
I always thought about that. Like, so do y'all, like, as comics, do y'all have to battle with yourself to do y'all have to think if a joke is good enough to put it on stage or put it in a video? Like,
yeah.
The
criteria is, everything I find funny. The scary part about comedy is subjective like a motherfucker.
100%.
My thing is, if you whack, you whack, though, bro. There's some comics that's just fucking whack, bro. They not funny at all. Mm-hmm. At the same time, if you're a funny person, you have a lot of my jokes come to me in my dreams.
Yeah, me too. I got to
I'll wake up and be like, oh, shit. That's why I utilize voice notes.
I got to write it down. I got to not be lazy. Like, yo, take out this voice note. Record this. This is going to be funny.
So if you notice, anytime before a show, I always got AirPods on, and I'm like, I'm not talking to nobody.
You're listening to your
I'm listening notes. To my jokes, right? Mm-hmm. And then when I listen back to it, I'm like, It was an episode of Seinfeld like that, and he listened. He had a dream about a joke, and then he wrote it down, and he woke up and said it. He like, this shit ain't funny. This shit what?
That's 90% of the jokes.
That shit happened to me all the time. But this shit don't be hitting.
You know why that is? And this is a rule in comedy in general. It's not that it's not funny anymore. It's like you don't remember the same voice you were in.
Right.
It's the voice of the joke. Because I could say something to you right now that is not funny, and then somebody could say it in a different way, the exact same
nigga, phrase. You know what I always say, bro?
That's hilarious.
Sing a DMX song in your voice.
Right.
That shit gonna sound garbage. It's
horrible. Yeah,
so does that mean DMX can't rap?
No, DMX got a gift.
Okay.
Because if you don't say it in his cadence, it ain't gonna hit the same.
That's a great analogy. I understand it. When you put it like that, I understand
it. Son, you say DMX shit. I already sound like DMX, so I'm a bad example.
Nigga compared his voice to DMX is all the way crazy.
But I'm not the one who says that.
So you're the type of person that let other people put the battery in your
bro,
back.
Nigga, do you listen to my. Nigga,
I've never listened to your voice. Okay. I've never heard anything you've
First said of all, I told you who you sound like. Everybody who listened to the show right now, close your eyes if you're watching it on YouTube and listen to him and tell me this guy don't have the exact same speaking voice as Drake.
I'm going to tell you every time I'm flattered by that, yo. Drake
they
is
have
my
the
guy.
Same voice.
Drake is my guy.
Now that I think about it, you really
son,
do.
He had the same voice as Drake, son.
Last name ever. First name greatest. Like a sprained ankle, boy, I ain't nothing to play with.
But see, this is why you inadvertently go viral. Watch this logic, right? Watch this. I'm going to show y'all niggas something crazy. Drill rappers, right? This is going to fuck y'all head up. And it's going to fuck his head up especially because we from the same hood. You know what I mean? Why do you think Tekashi blew up? Do you make good music?
Hell no.
All right. Now, something like, you know, something is sonically pleasing and you don't know why?
Yeah.
Okay, so New York has a specific voice, a specific sound.
Sound, yeah.
In the 90s, when it first came out, it was like if you listen to Onyx, right? Let's play it. Watch. If you listen to Onyx, right? Onyx, Let's do it. Last Days Onyx. Hopefully this shit don't.
Yo, I worked with somebody who was Onyx's daughter at a call center.
Which one?
This girl, Tynese.
No, but which,
I don't know. Which member? I don't know which member of Onyx. She's like, yo, my dad is one of the members of Onyx.
That's
like,
oh. That's like so?
No, but it was worse because, like, bitch, why are you working at the call center?
Yo, you, who cares if you sticky fingers daughter, bitch? You,
why are you at this job making $18 an hour and your dad is a hip hop?
Yo, working with sticky fingers daughter is crazy, son.
Working an entry level 9 to 5 job. Like, I'm not shitting on it. I was also working there. But I'm like, yo, you, this nigga was at BET.
You come from somewhere.
He was at the BET Awards last year. That shit is crazy. And it wasn't even like, oh, he's my estranged father. He's my adopted dad.
Been around.
I haven't dead ass, like, dead ass, dad raised him.
Like, yo, my dad.
Yeah, but you gotta understand something. Rappers back in the 90s and shit ain't making no money. Them niggas was dead broke.
Yeah. No, rappers today ain't
I mean,
no more.
It's different. Money. I mean, but this is levels of Onyx, too. You got Fredro Starr, who did well. Mm. He was in movies and shit. Then you got Sticky Fingers, who did the best because he was in Blade. He was Blade.
Mm-hmm.
And he, you know what I'm saying? Nigga did a lot of different shit on Let's See.
He was Blade. He was Wesley Snipes?
No, he was Blade. Nigga, like, there was a Blade that came out with Sticky Fingers in it.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah. The cock out of one.
I forgot what.
But if you Big DS or Suave, them niggas is whack, son.
I think it was probably Suave or something.
Yeah, like, them niggas ain't. Nobody give a fuck about them niggas, son. Respectfully.
Like, okay. yo, my dad is one of the backup dancers. This nigga's on the stage.
Okay, so look. What is this? Okay. We're going to go to YouTube. Now, I'm sorry, y'all. That's why we filtering it out. I should have been sounding already. My back. Okay, so you go to Onyx, right? So listen to this song. Okay. Now we're in the wrong one because now I got to go through ads. That's why you got to subscribe to YouTube Premium, y'all.
This nigga watching YouTube like poor people.
All right, here we go. Listen.
South Suicide Queens.
Hear the voice? Born sickness. That's a New York voice, bro. Mm-hmm. Shit is about to change, motherfuckers.
It is about to change.
This is some authentic New York shit right here.
I'm a America's nightmare. Young black and just don't give a. I just wanna get my liberty up. So off the 9 to 5 and what trying to slave us. Women in my wages, slamming my sickness up in cages.
That's the point, right? So that was like a authentic New York sound.
Yeah.
Right? Back in the days, right? So now this little fucking blonde head, I mean rainbow head dickhead come out and you listen to him, you're like, oh shit, this nigga.
He has, like, the same cadence or same, like, style.
Bro,
sound.
If you listen, listen to this nigga's voice, bro. Look, listen. Right? So, boom. We got that part, right? So, now, you got all of these new little Bronx drill rappers that come out, right?
Mm-hmm.
And now, you don't even know why these niggas is blowing up like that. But you got 6ix9ine voice in your head?
Yeah.
Listen to this shit. Listen. Listen, bro. They got the same voice, son. They all do. Watch. And they don't even know they doing it. But it's
just a natural way to talk. Like,
see?
It's a natural aggression that come with that come with being from New York.
You close your eyes, you hear 6ix9ine, son.
Don't run no trap.
See what I'm saying? Yeah. So when I say that, niggas get mad at me. But you see how I went down the timeline?
Yeah, yeah.
So
yeah,
I went Onyx, 6ix9ine, then back to the Bronx Drill because this shit came after 6ix9ine, right?
Yeah.
So 6ix9ine blew the fuck up, bro. Like, but he a snitch. We know all these things about him. And in that space, how could he blow up, right? And then you got these other little niggas who really real street trail niggas, right?
Yeah.
But they also sound like 6ix9ine. But they don't sound like 6ix9ine. They sound like New York.
Right.
That's a New York sound, bro.
It's like a grimy, gritty voice.
Right, like, so that's what I'm saying. Like, something can be... This is what me and the South get disconnected at, right? I always get it to the South niggas, right? I always tell these niggas, like, yo, it's possible to be a good artist and can't rap.
Mm-hmm.
Like the South popularized that. Like the South invented that shit. Making great music, but not being able to rap.
Facts. Like Boss Man D-Lo can't rap. He just talking.
What's that show?
I'm driving. You want to get in with me? If I was, you thought I was bad in school, all that shit. That shit is
when I was
regular.
In school.
That shit is whack.
You know what I'm talking about?
Nah.
Bro,
I was bad at fucking school. Now I'm down trying to dodge the Senate. Just bought a lavish store, pair of shoes, 12.
Son, 50. You had to hear that song, bro.
Regular.
You want to be in my house?
Get it with me. That shit is mad.
Bro,
regular.
Come on, son. You had to hear this song, son. It's the worst song ever made, bro.
I grew up in the suburbs. I know Celine Dion.
That's not it. It's the worst song ever made, son. You heard it, bro.
I know Luca Vandross.
That one right there.
Kev, you know the song, bro. It's everywhere, bro.
You had to hear this shit. Yeah.
You had to hear this song, bro.
Brown.
There's no way you didn't hear this song.
I was bad at fucking school. Now I'm trying to dodge a Senate. Just walked out the lavish store, pair of shoes, 12 feet.
I promise you, I've never.
You
heard
some
that's crazy. Wow.
there's heavy niggotry involved in this song, and I don't want no problem.
But that's the thing, though. Something that's sonically pleasing don't got nothing to do with lyrics.
Well, yeah.
Right? And that's what New Yorkers, that's what we fail to forget. Yeah, we rap better than everybody.
Right.
Except for probably niggas from Philly, because Philly niggas are the best rappers in the world, in my opinion.
Who from Philly that got it like that, besides...
nigga, Beanie Siegel, Freeway, Cassidy.
But who Philly produced
Prince?
In the last 10 years?
Right, but they like New York niggas. Like, we... But what do we have to do in order to blow back up?
What do you mean blow back up?
Like for New York to get it to have a big artist again.
Yeah, I gotta kill somebody.
No, we had to emulate the South.
Mm.
That's how New York came back in the game. That's how New York got like Nash back on the.
What you mean? Like, what you mean with the drill shit?
No, drill is a new, authentic New York sound.
Nah, but I feel like New York drill came from Chicago.
Came from the UK. UK
yeah.
Chicago stole. Back. Drill. I mean, UK got drill from Chicago, but UK created their own version of it.
Yeah.
And then New Yorkers got their beats from
the Chicago niggas.
No, from the UK niggas.
But the Chicago niggas got it from the UK niggas.
But the Chicago niggas beats and UK beats are different.
They one in the same, though.
Really?
Yeah, they be one in the same, if you really listen to it.
Because I'm thinking like a, for instance, what's his name? The number one.
Wilson Phillips?
No, the fat nigga with the dreads that produced Chief Keef.
Young Chop. Yeah.
Like, Chop beat don't sound like, it's more like hi-hats and shit with that. Because drill is like.
But the UK niggas, they'd take a Chicago beat and just throw a couple pitches on it just so they could write. It's really one of the same.
Well, Chicago gang culture started drill.
Exactly. That's why
I will say this too, bro. Here's the funniest thing about drill music, right? First of all, in order to be a drill rapper, you gotta be a gang member. Like, you have to, it's no way, right? But what happened is, like with all things, there's people outside of the gang culture who make drill music that blow up bigger than them.
Facts.
Yeah. Ice Spice. Mm. That's drill music.
Nah, I wouldn't consider Ice Spice drill music.
What? That's drill.
I wouldn't consider that.
What you mean? Look at the beat.
Nah, I wouldn't consider it drill music. That's like.
So what kind of beat is that though? That's drill.
Are you being biased because she's a woman?
Nah, not even because it's a lot
you
of
you hate women.
It's a lot of It's a lot of women from New York who really drill. Who really on a drill?
Name two female role models you've ever had. Look at you raising misogynist ass kids.
He's trolling, bro. He's trolling.
I'm playing a little bit. This nigga don't have no female role models in his life. He couldn't think of one who's not your mom or your aunt.
Nothing. Michelle Obama.
Michelle
great
Obama.
Role model.
Everybody want a default.
Great role model.
Let's move on for this because we dragging this shit, y'all.
I say all that to say the apology. We got back. We got away from it. J. Cole's apology was crazy.
And try to listen, these niggas ain't paying us. Shout out to the people that lost Sundays. This shit is good, but these niggas ain't paying us, so we gonna move along.
Yeah. Mm. Can I say before we move on, I respect the apology.
I don't.
Nah, yeah, I don't.
Yeah.
I don't respect it, bro.
I respect, and I knew that y'all were gonna have a different opinion from me because y'all niggas aren't healed niggas. Y'all don't be
doing
the
this
work.
Rap.
No,
this
no,
rap.
No. See.
Y'all not healed.
See, this is the problem with people like Kevin, right? This is where the geek culture coming up.
Right.
Because niggas like Kevin Deane. They fuse. Listen, I'm. If I do something to hurt a nigga feelings, he my boy, whoever, I apologize.
Right.
But nigga, this is right, bro. All right. So if LeBron dunk on a nigga and put all his nuts all in his face, you gonna say sorry to him?
It's a little bit different.
What do you mean? It's the same thing. It's
competition.
No. Rap. Listen. First, let me get this. This is what they stole from me, right? Mm-hmm. Since Hov and Nas, and this is before my son was even born, bro. That shit was before my son. That was the last time we saw two heavyweights go at it, mm-hmm. right? But even with Hov and Nas, that shit could have spilled over to some street shit because those were two street niggas, bro.
Yeah,
and they peoples really was beefing behind that. But it never escalated past that. It was bars, and now look where we at. Jay and Nas are friends, right?
Yeah.
Kendrick and Cole are friends. But Drake and Cole got this thing where, oh, nah, big three, let's have fun with it. Kendrick like, nah, fuck out of here, nigga. I'm cut from that Jay-Z cloth, that Big Daddy Kane cloth, that Nas cloth. I'm from that cloth, nigga. Ain't no friendships over here, nigga.
Yeah.
This is a competitive sport. Rap is a sport, nigga. So what you said, nigga, do you watch battle rap, bro?
Yeah.
They say the worst shit in the world to each other, and they hang out.
Don't give a nigga
I know half battle. Of these niggas, bro. Bro, they hang out. They club together. They friends. Nigga get in your face, yo, suck my dick and spit all in your face. Talk about your mother.
Battle rap is completely different than what we're talking about.
But battle rap is how rap started.
Yeah, that's the essence of rap.
Battle rap is the original. But Kendrick is cut from that cloth. Word. And J. Cole, you can't be a nigga talking about, I'm the big, what he said? He said, yeah, is it KD, Aubrey, or me?
Yeah, but I'm
Muhammad Ali. You can't say that shit and expect Kendrick, what, nigga?
He went out there to do what he did. People put the battery in his back. And then afterwards, it didn't feel right in his soul.
Because he a sucker. Nah, yeah, that's no, but my thing, but KD, look, bro. Why would you say that? How could you say, yo, I'm Muhammad Ali? That means I'm better than Kendrick and better than Drake. And diss Drake low-key because he said, I'm the one they call when they shit ain't hitting.
Right.
He said it on Drake's song.
Nah, word. That's a shot.
He dissed Drake too.
That's a shot.
So, he always talking about how he the best one. So when a nigga say, no, you not, I am. Fuck the big three, nigga. It's just big me. Fuck out of here. I'm not on that. And then you responded, cool.
Cool.
You didn't say nothing about his mother.
Right.
You said how you felt, and you really felt that way. Stop lying. J. Cole is too smart and too good of a rapper to even go that route, my nigga.
Right.
He meant all that shit. Now you going to come back and retract it because you scared, nigga?
I don't know that he's scared. I think with your example with LeBron, at the end of the day, it don't have to spill out into my personal life. Once we get done on the court, it's on the court. And your example with rap battles, these niggas have their checks on the line. So there's been niggas like Math Hoffa that have punched a nigga in the face for some shit, and they lose their bag. So now rap battles are incentivized. Yo, make it look as egregious as possible. But if you respond to that shit, you're not getting paid for this. And this might be the one, your $30,000 that you get for the whole year or whatever the case may be.
So, you think J. Cole is in danger of being in that space?
No, that's what I'm saying. Those are not a metaphor that you can compare because they're not in the same situation. I think that with
Cole, my point of saying that is this has no chance of turning into some street shit.
It always has a chance.
Not with them guys. Everybody knows. Not with those guys. Not even with their camps.
That's the problem.
Neither one of them. They don't even hang with gangsters. They regular guys.
J. Cole is a nice guy. So he's, I don't, the easy.
So is Kendrick and Drake.
Right. It's easy to say, oh, this nigga's scared. That's the default answer. It's like, no, nigga, I'm just a nice person.
Bro, you was dick eating and glazing at your own fucking tour, man. That's corny, son.
Bro, it's natural in rap to have bravado and to be like, I'm the nicest nigga. But to be like, all right, well, now I'm going to have to find secrets about you. I'm going to have to be salacious. Every single time that it goes into rap beef, the only way that rap beef goes crazy is if niggas like start telling truths about a person.
But watch this, though. I think we know less about Cole than Kendrick. Cole is also an elusive dude. Right. Isn't he married?
Yeah.
Yeah, like, what can you say? What can, first of all, watch this. Cole is just as elusive as Kendrick.
Right.
So they both got the same, like, level of dirt on each other. They both regular guys. None of these niggas like jury. They're not flashy. They're not controversial. So Kendrick got just as much ammo as Cole has. That means it's all bars.
It's all right. It should be all right. Word.
I think that everybody.
And also, two things. One, yeah. Kendrick started.
Mm-hmm.
Nigga,
Kendrick got mad about some bullshit.
Yo, KD, if you punch me in my mouth, son, I promise you, when I hit you back, son, I'm not saying sorry to you, son.
Fair. Fair. Yo, that would be like, yo, we talking, I'm like, hey, yo, I'm the best podcaster in this space, yo, nigga. Yo, we all nice, but I'm the best. And then you come out with a whole podcast, be like, yo, fuck Kevin. Everything Kevin mm-hmm. ever stood for, that nigga corny, that nigga lame.
I'm standing on it.
Bro, why, yo, why the hostility, nigga? I'm just over here hyping myself up. Why are you feeling so offended right now?
Because you because he took a shot at Kendrick in that song. And he always doing it.
I feel like he bigged him up more than he took a shot at him and said, yo, we're the best three.
Yeah, but he said, yeah, but I'm the best,
you
best yourself of us.
On top of all of us. Yeah, pause.
Okay.
That's what he did.
Yeah. And then he apologized for that.
Bro, that was a nasty apology, son. That was a nasty. Because he didn't even say anything, though.
Yeah.
Because you said his album was mid, so?
Yeah, he disrespected his discography, and he didn't.
Son, I would have dissed his ugly. Son, I would have came for Baby Keem. Baby Keem, ugliest nigga to come out of L.A. That's an ugly nigga. So, I just said about Keem, how Keem came out. I thought Keem was next up. Because Keem album was fire, nigga. That's an ugly ass nigga, though.
That I feel like Baby Keem and Jid got to go at each other. He can't come at Jid. He gotta let his little mans do
let
that.
Let me tell you something, son. I got smoke for everybody catching strays and the whole whoever's standing next to you, son.
But that's your type of energy. You a nigga who always want the smoke. You looking for it. Cole, do you think that you and Cole have the same persona?
No.
You're two completely different people, and that's okay.
But also, I'm not going to say nothing that would even indicate that I want smoke. Cole did that.
Right.
He a bitch, bro. Respectfully.
I feel like
we stayed on this subject for a half hour, nigga.
Get out of here.
Let's move on. Pack these niggas up, son. Cole's a bitch. You don't think he is?
Hey, Cole, I respect you. Dog.
I respect Cole as one of the greatest MCs, but nigga, he's not in a good conversation no more than me.
Hey, we healing, see, y'all.
That's over with.
We healing in 2024.
Healing. Give me a fucking break. All right, let's get into the funny shit now. So look at the shit, y'all. Fuck. God damn it. Okay, I guess we gotta move to something else. That didn't hit right. So anyway, it was a dude. Let's see. Please work. All right. So your man.
Anytime the nigga says your man, I'm
so
like.
So your man, Terrence Howard.
Oh, no.
Was.
Your main.
Was beefing about something. But that's not what my focal point was. Check this out. Yeah, this was crazy to me. Hiring us, we got him. Look at this. Work. Y'all ready?
Yeah. Because I did see where you were coming. You said you want to retire, then you came back.
Yeah.
So what was that transition like? Why did you decide to come back, even if it's for a brief moment?
Well, no, it's because finances. You have to. The moment that,
son,
you know, you go through the 6-year criminal investigation.
Yo, what's
you
up?
Know, it's been $3-4 million.
I don't even care about nothing you're talking about, son.
Because it's just. Playing money.
Why he got the Farrah Fawcett and on right now?
So first of all, this still shot is crazy.
This nigga like Goldie Hawn.
So my man look like Kitty from that 70s show.
Yo,
son.
Yo, dead ass.
The mom.
Yeah.
This is crazy, son. Son, I don't care about nothing he talking about. I'm like, you know what? This must be some kind of parody show.
That's a hairpiece, right?
Bro, I don't know if that's a wig.
He didn't grow his shit out and press it and perm it, right?
Son, I say, yo, this is a fake show, and he's doing this for a movie role.
That's Lucius Lyon.
Like he's still in character from
Empire.
Nah, from Hustle and Flow.
Hustle and Flow.
This is crazy.
This is nuts, bro.
Nigga, need a corn roll.
Son, this is a real show, bro.
Their whole thing is to bleed you out.
Right.
Now, fascinating thing. It'd be 2 points. I had an issue with Fox and CA at Fox and Disney.
So listen. How could you expect anybody to take anything you're saying serious when you're doing this kind of foolishness?
This nigga
bro.
Talking about I got an issue with Fox and CNN. Nigga, I got an issue with you, nigga. I got an issue with your hair, dog.
Son, if I was Fox, I would get that nigga Baker acted. I would send, you know, you remember back in the days when niggas was crazy?
Yeah.
And they would send two orderlies to come get you.
Yeah, yo, you gotta go sit down somewhere for a minute. Yo.
This is insane, son.
And the crazy part is the beard and the mustache match.
It's so much. It's so much to unpack. It.
Why did he go brunette?
Bro, yeah, that's nasty. The shirt with no beater, the skin to silk combat is nasty work.
It's crazy. With the collar from the 70s. The collar
is crazy. Son, this can't be real.
He looked like a Dallas Cowboys cheerleader from the 70s, dog.
So not only did he look like Kitty and Kitty's daughter on this. Have you ever seen that 70s show?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. She was slutty.
She was sexy, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Remember they replaced her?
That was whack.
Yeah. The original girl was bad. Then they replaced her and tried to act like we didn't notice.
Let's move on because that was crazy.
I blame Fresh Prince. They did it with Aunt Viv, and now everybody think they could do it.
All right, I want to get my son involved in some shit because this is crazy, right? So women in America. Well, how old would you say, like when you see women on social media or women online talking shit about men? What age group would you put them in to have that level of confidence? Because a lot of women do it. But to confidently sit on a podcast or confidently get online and make these videos about men and what men should bring to the table and blah, 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 blah. How old do you think these women are?
22 to 35.
That's a big gap. I wouldn't say 22. I would say about 28 to 35.
They're a little bit older.
Say a little older because my age group, like 20.
They're having good time. Like
23 to 25.
They're not even looking for a man.
They shaking ass though.
Yeah, they not worried about it. If a nigga offering the money, if a nigga offering, you feel me, be there and do that for them, taking it. But they don't really care about going 50-50.
They don't have enough life experience yet to know what type of nigga they want.
Word.
So check this out. Look what's going on in China, y'all. And this is regular shit in China. Check this out.
How old do you have to be then as a woman to be considered a leftover?
I think around 30, like after 30 years old. But if you're after 35 years old, then just you're out of the market. You know, it's more like you don't have to consider about getting married anymore. Just to maybe have a child on your own is the best way for you.
Ladies, in China, if you are 31 and up, you don't even have the option of getting a man no more. Mm. And 31 is young, bro.
Young.
Yeah, I'm gonna say
stupid young. Word. I'm 32.
31 is young as fuck. If you're not married in China, it's a dub for you.
We can't live by Chinese standards, though.
No, but what I'm saying is American women need to understand. We gotta have understanding, son.
Understanding.
Right? This is just China for an example. Mm-hmm. Other places even worse.
You remember we were having that conversation about why there's no Asian midgets, why you don't ever see Asian midgets? Remember that?
They're dead?
Yeah, they kill them. They drown them when they're born. It's a liability for them.
It's like Athetes from 300, son. That hunchback nigga wasn't supposed to live.
Yeah, you gotta go.
Because this is what happens, bro. What happens is, but I blame men. Mm. I blame men.
It's always on us. We got to take accountability.
No. Because there's such a man called a simp. Mm. Right? There's a group of niggas who have made... Well, you know what? I don't blame men. Because it's a game that everybody playing.
Right.
Right? Because the dude know, I got the money. She wants the money. I'm going to do X, Y, and Z for her. And then I'm going to be done with her. Right? What happens is when these women get used up and they off the market, now they 35, 40, talking about how niggas ain't shit. That's typically what happens.
Yeah.
That's what typically, it's like, yo, shorty, who said this shit before?
Of course you're going to think niggas ain't shit because you've been getting used and tossed out for the last.
I think my bro Corey Holcomb said, no. Kevin Samuels, I think Kevin Samuels, rest in peace to the Godfather. I think he probably even said it. Niggas said, how come women are ready to settle down out of their prom?
Mm-hmm.
Like you, women, first of all,
as a fact.
Son, you my son, right? You're 23. When you get 35, you're going to look way better than you look right now. Way better. You're going to get bigger. Like, you're going to look better, bro. Do you feel like you look... I saw a picture of you now. I'm posting it. This nigga look crazy. So you think Terrence Howard has some wild hair dudes, my nigga? Son, that nigga
I had the Terrence Howard. Son, I had the Marcus Houston immature perm,
bro,
dog.
He had the nasty. I thought it was a Halloween costume. My man had the mushroom joint. Nasty haircuts. He didn't know what to do with his facial hair.
I had the chin strap for way too long.
Nasty works.
A chin strap with no mustache.
Before I got introduced to the gym, I didn't know what to do with my facial hair either. Mm-hmm. I didn't know about the gym. Men, we age way more gracefully than women. That's no insult to women. It's just what it is.
Right.
We age better than they do.
Depending on the culture. Because a white nigga getting older looks crazy.
Watch this. Kevin Samuels did this. I'm going to do it. In a sexual marketplace, put a 18-year-old woman next to an 82-year-old man. Who's more valuable?
8-year-old woman?
A 25-year-old woman next to a 25-year-old man.
Are we just talking looks?
Sexual.
Oh, sexual? 25.
Woman.
Woman.
30.
I'm never looking at a man as valuable.
I'm just saying, like, who do you think is more desirable by the opposite sex?
Maybe the 30-year-old woman still.
35.
Gotta be the nigga. He started getting money.
40.
Nigga.
45.
Dude, that dude got bread.
You see where it stopped? You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It keep going up for us. Yeah. Because a man will always hold value based off what he has.
Facts. Yeah.
Women hold values based off how they look.
Right.
So once the looks fade, it's a dub for you. That's nigga, fine. Listen. First of all, a man with money gotta pay like he weigh, right?
Mm-hmm.
A woman with money also got to pay like she weigh.
Mm-hmm.
So a dude could buy a bad bitch. I don't give a fuck how much money you got as a woman. If you a 50-year-old washed up fat chick, you ain't getting no good looking dude.
Yeah. And that 50-year-old washed up fat chick with
the
money.
The 50-year-old good looking dude could get a good looking 20-year-old.
That 50-year-old woman with money only wants to date a nigga who also has as much money, if not more money than her.
100%.
So her standards are high, but her options are low.
100%. And also, women have this thing where they always, they don't corner the market.
Yeah.
They actually have, they don't diversify their portfolios. Mm-hmm. Like for us, right, as black men, somebody asked him another, we don't have options. I mean, we don't have standard. Like, right, we understand as black men, we're at the top of the food chain.
Mm-hmm.
This is no diss to other men of other races. I know that black men and darker skinned black men are the most desirable men on the planet. Right. Period, point blank. There's no, nobody ever said, oh, I want me a short Puerto Rican. Nobody wants you, nigga. Like, that's not the way it works.
Yeah.
Right? That's why we have a porn category called BBC. Right. And it's always a dark-skinned black dude. That's just, it is what it is. Even if it ain't true, they're still curious.
Yeah.
That's why when we go to other countries, women flock over us.
But it's a it's a fetishized thing.
Fine.
Yeah, it's fine.
It never goes away.
Yo, I just want to make sure that we're not blurring the lines. Because a lot of times people are having different arguments. They're like, who's the most desired to be married? Who's the most sought after relationship-wise?
Right.
But if you're a nigga who your priority is like, yo, I'm talking about who wants to fuck the most.
Facts.
We're winning.
Yeah, we are.
Then that's a conversation that, yeah.
But desirable, but hold on. Women want to marry who they want to fuck. A woman is not... Listen, watch this. Watch this. I'm going to say some real shit to y'all real quick. A woman, if she want to fuck you, she also want to marry you.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
Ideally, she wants you to act the way designed as a husband, if she's attracted to you. We know that the bitch with the BBL is not wifey material.
Right.
Facts.
And we'll marry the sex, though.
Right.
Nah, what?
Women are going to contest you online. What they're going to say is we're not all a monolith. That's not true for everybody. But what you're saying is 100% fact, because what that woman will do, she'll take the good dick that she has and try to control and change and make him into the man that she wants him to be.
Bro.
Instead of finding the man that she wants and settling for like less than great sex or whatever the case is, she'll always take the fuckboy douchebag nigga and try to make him a good dude.
Always, bro. Like,
and it's going to fail every time.
Because you know why? Because we're realists.
Right.
We understand that the woman that's highly desirable, just because we want her, other dudes want her too.
Right.
And she knows that. And we know her looks are going to fade one day. Mm-hmm. So we'll get the 6 or 7 mm-hmm. who's going to maintain that appearance for the rest of her life.
Facts.
Because the bad bitch is going to get whacked one day.
I've taken so many fives out of terrible situations. Nigga, I'm like, bro, the I'm five, like Prince Charming with that shit.
Listen.
I will see a Cinderella and be like, yeah, I could put her in a ball gown and some glass slippers.
The
and
five, she'll be a princess. You could turn the five, but you could turn the five into a 10.
Yeah, no.
Because facts. The five, that's a five if she's way a little too much. If she don't know what to do with her hair. Bro, I've met so many women who are not physically attractive. But their energy is so beautiful. Dope, son, yeah. That, and if you love them the right way,
mm-hmm.
their physical will begin to match that because of how you treat them.
Wow, that's a fact.
Yeah, the black culture didn't grow up on this, but go look up a movie called She's All That, nigga. It's a very it's a very easy thing to do, bro. Is to see a bitch with glasses and a ponytail and be like, yo, I can make her over.
Bro, listen.
And make her
sing. I know that now as an older nigga, bro. I remember in high school, I was superficial as hell. I used to dump chicks for the dumbest shit, son. Yeah. Like, I remember I dumped the chick because of her fucking winter coat, son. There were certain brands you couldn't wear.
You wearing that baby fat shit every day, yo. Shorty, get some North Face.
Shorty, nigga said baby fat. Shorty pulled up. It was a brand called Boxing Bear, son. Because in the springtime, you know, in New York, like, you see a chick, you know, they wear Tims and coats like us.
Yeah.
But springtime, they showed you like, damn, like you ain't know what their body look like.
Yeah, yeah, they get to put it out.
So springtime, I got with her. And I ain't recognize her because I guess during the winter, she had the bullshit on.
Yeah.
So I didn't pay her no mind. So springtime, I got with her. And then I dealt with her during the summertime and back again during the beginning of the school year. Because in New York, it started to get cold around October, November. Coat time. I'm like, ooh, see, you know, we pulling out all type of North Face.
That's the best time.
Low bubble. That's when you dress your best.
Yeah.
For guys.
Yeah.
Girls dress their best in the spring. But men, we dress our best.
In the cold.
In the cold. Shorty came with the coat. I'm like, and we always met at the front door. She pulled up with that coat.
That boxing
My man looked at, I'm like, yo, I'm going to holler at you later.
Yeah.
What's wrong, boy? I'm like, I'll talk to you later. I'm like, yo, my nigga, I gotta wrap that up, son.
I gotta dead that.
I can't. Wow. I can't get with that coat, son. But guess what though? Now, she's a lawyer. She's bad. But see, that's why in New York in the 90s when I was growing up, older dudes, it was acceptable. That's why nobody batted an eye when R. Kelly was fucking with huh?
Went to the bathroom.
You gotta go downstairs. Well, R. Kelly was there. Where the keys at? This nigga got up there in a podcast, going to the bathroom. Huh?
This nigga's so unprofessional.
Yeah. When R. Kelly was dating Aaliyah.
Yeah.
That's why nobody batted an eye at it because
we've changed as a society. We have higher standards and we're better at protecting people. There's more information on the internet. We're more woke than we've ever been. That's why, yo.
Well, listen, here's my thought process, Kev. People don't change, laws change.
Right.
Right? Because
society changes.
Laws change. Society don't change. Laws make society change.
Yeah.
Because do you think that if slavery was still... How many white friends you got? A lot.
They used to justify it in the Bible.
But you got... No, I'm talking about American...
I actually don't got a lot of white friends. I got like one white friend.
Well, there's white people you cool with.
Yeah, of course.
All the white people we know, at some point, somebody in their lineage was a fucking slave master.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Do you think they have enough wealth... you know what? If slavery came back, they wouldn't own...
No, they would.
Right.
Right.
You saw The Color Purple, right?
Yeah.
On The Color Purple, the nigga knocked on the door like, yo, I want to marry your daughter. Shorty was like 14.
Yeah.
You think if the statutory laws changed, nigga wouldn't start fucking little girls again?
Right.
Right. So that's what I'm saying. Like, laws force people to change.
Laws dictate human morality. Right.
I watched some shit yesterday, bro, and it fucked my head up. And me being a history buff I am, it's amazing how much shit get erased from history, son. Like, for instance... It was some shit called the German-American, what's the word? It was an organization back in the 1930s and 20s. Bro, they had Nazis in New York.
Yeah.
It was huge.
They let the Nazis flee everywhere.
Bro, after. It was, no, it was a Nazi party in New York prepared to overthrow the government.
Wow.
It was crazy. It was called the German... Bro, you gotta read up on this shit, son. This is my shit.
I didn't know you was a history buff like that.
The German-American Bund. The German-American Bund, bro, a lot of people don't know about this. These are the shit they don't talk about. The German-American Bund, look at this shit, bro. The German-American Bund, or the German-American Federation, Nazi organization, which was established in 1936 as a successor to the Friends of the New Germany. The organization chose its new order to emphasize American credentials after it was accused of being unpatriotic. The Bund was allowed to consist of only American citizens of German descent. Its main goal was to promote a favorite view of Nazi Germany. Bro, they don't talk about that shit, bro.
Right.
They don't talk about how in the 1940s, fucking Americans had Japanese concentration camps.
Yeah.
Bro, that shit is American fucking terrorism, son.
Yeah.
They don't talk about how they don't talk about how the Ku Klux Klan was literally terrorists, son.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm like, these niggas was really domestic terrorists, son.
All over.
But that's what I'm saying. That shit, that ideology. So just because the Bund was eradicated and they, bro, the idea still exists, right? So if the idea is still there, it still exists.
It's like them playing the Birth of the Nation in the White House when it was aired. And
bro,
it's like
insane, bro.
Ku Klux Klan propaganda, basically, the whole movie.
Son, I don't even know how we got so left, but...
But, yeah, no, the whole thing is like, yo, the society governs how our morality, what we do and what we think as a culture.
Right.
That's to my point. Like, yo, did you see the Quiet on Set doc?
No.
It's a documentary that came out a few weeks ago about Nickelodeon and all the salacious shit.
No, I haven't seen it yet, but I did want to check that out.
Great. It was a great watch. But I'm watching it the whole time, and I'm like, yo, y'all are trying to kill niggas for the whole thing. They played it to make it seem like Dan Schneider, the head of this television company, was doing nasty shit with the kids. And I'm like watching this like, yo, come on, not Dan. And he never did nothing to the kids, but he made hostile work environments. He would yell on set. He was kind of sexist. He was talking down to the women and shit.
Right.
And then what they really try to hone in on him for is innuendo. He was putting a lot of sexual innuendo in children's shows.
I know. I saw the Ariana Grande shit. I saw a bunch of wild shit.
A couple of people.
But I think that's just the time.
That's my whole point. Like, yo, it was a sign of the times.
Right. Go watch Eddie Murphy Raw.
Go watch anything back in the day.
Yeah.
Like, we have grown and evolved as a society. So to try to put somebody on trial for what we were living like 30 years ago is not fair.
Let me ask you this, though, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that shit is counterproductive?
What, going back and...
Demonizing people. For instance, right? I'm not going to put a camera in front of a... Now, racism is painstakingly bad.
Right.
Right? But calling a little person a midget or a handicapped person a retard, these are words that were... Like, the word midget literally means that. Yeah. Retard means that, right? At what point... Do we sit back and decide these words mean, like faggot, right?
Right.
And I shouldn't say that. That word, it literally means a bundle of sticks.
Mm-hmm.
In Europe, it means a cigarette.
Cigarette.
Right? So I can get that word being a derogatory word, right? But at what point do these people stand up and say, hey, you know what? I don't like that word. Let's change it, right? The F word was always meant to be offensive, right? Nigga was always an offensive word.
Yeah.
There's no nice way to say it unless we're saying it to each other as a term of endearment.
Right.
Right? So, but there's other words. It's like people are joining. I was like calling a girl a fat girl.
Yeah.
It's like, yo, come on, son. Yo, BBW? Oh, call me, I'm not fat, I'm a BBW. Oh, so you're a big, beautiful woman? You know what that does? It coddles people.
Yeah.
These words, they coddle them. It coddles you to make it okay to be what you are, right? So it's like, I'm not fat. Fat girls got to go to the gym and lose weight or they're going to get heart disease and die. But BBWs are beautiful and accepted.
Yeah. So I don't want, because I think there's a lot of points that you're making here and I agree with some of them. I don't want to conflate them. I think that like racism, sexism, homophobia, all of that is wrong. But I think that every group should be allowed to be criticized. And I think that every group should be open to jokes. If they're jokes, they're jokes.
But not even the jokes, bro. I think what happens is some groups insert themselves into causes that aren't theirs.
Everybody's got victim mentality.
Right, because watch this, right? No, I think people have malicious intent.
Mm.
Because at one point, there were dudes who were cross-dressers that just wanted to dress like a bitch.
Yeah.
They didn't have no intentions on being, they didn't suffer from gender dysphoria. They don't want to be a woman. They just want to wear their wife's clothes and be weirdos.
Yeah.
Like on like a fucking Buffalo Bill from Sons of the Lambs.
Yeah.
Right?
John Wayne Gacy.
That nigga's not a tranny, bro.
Right.
He's not transgendered.
Right.
But what they do is they insert themselves into that real cause.
It's real.
And fuck it up.
That's real. But that's where there needs to be discernment. Because at the end of the day, what they're going to do is say, oh, yo, this is what black people's struggle was in the 1960s. This is civil rights problems.
Right.
We're going to model our victimization based on that. And that's how we get fucking...
NAMBLA?
Huh? No. That's a far reach. But like equal rights campaigns but down the road.
That's what they did too.
Yeah. They're going to insert themselves in real life issues. That's why I hate when niggas generalize and be like, oh, yo, all these trans people, all they want to do is change our kids and shit.
But see, that's why I have a solution for all of that. A, if you have a personal feeling or belief that's your own,
mm-hmm.
don't demonize or guilt anybody because of how you feel.
Right.
That's your shit, right? So if you, Kev, and I hope that shit never happens, you say, hey, you know, I'm not Kevin anymore. I'm Kelly.
Yeah.
Nigga, you Kevin, bro. Like, I don't want to fuck up nothing, right? I don't want to go the wrong way with that, right? That is your delusion.
Yeah.
Right? That's what you feel.
Don't force your reality on me is what you're saying.
Right. And that's not fair because me not agreeing with what's in your head because I'm looking at something.
Yeah.
And telling me I'm a bad person is fucked up. It's not right, bro. And they're doing that to our kids.
Mm.
It's not right, son.
I feel as though...
It's coddling.
I think that a few people are doing that. A small minority of a big group.
Right.
And society in general is trying to make it seem like, yo, this is everybody's agenda.
And it's really not that this serious, is the bro.
Yo, I have trans friends.
Me too.
I got trans friends that are cool
me
as
too.
Fuck. And like, yo, I
know. We know comedians who are.
Yeah, and I'm like, yo, I respect your pronouns. I'll do everything that, like, I'll try to the best 100%. Of my ability. I fuck up sometimes. I call, like, oh, she, my bad, they, he. Oh.
Like, I don't know, like Mario, right? He looked like he's transitioning, right?
But he's not trans.
But see, that's what I'm talking about.
It's all about what he identifies as.
That's the shit I'm talking about. And I'm not saying Mario's fake because I fuck with Mario.
Yeah.
Salute to Mario, right? But over the years since I've known him, he's
got more feminine. He's dressed.
He's shoes now, long hair.
He caught me off guard.
He looks like nigga. I thought it was a girl a couple of times.
I got jammed up almost a couple of times. A couple of times from behind, I'm like, yo, who that new bad bitch out here? Who is that?
No way, son. No.
And then I was like, yo, excuse me. Hold my vodka soda real quick. I'm about to go introduce myself. Oh, shit, Mario. Oh, yo, nigga.
No, my bad, bro. No, this nigga really be pulling up like a shorty.
With the heels, with the crop tops and shit.
I'm like, yo, you can't be, son, you're going to get somebody jammed up.
Yo, I almost got jammed up.
No, because that's what I said. I don't know if he's trans or not. Like,
he's not. I've had conversations with him. He's not trans.
Let's move on. We almost an hour in, bro.
Man got out of Dodge at the right time. Son, your son was like, yo.
Where's this dude at? Is he at the door? Like, where he at? I am not. Speaking of LGBTQ, I want your take on this. This is crazy right here, bro.
Okay.
This is crazy, son. Check this shit out, bro.
Why don't sperm donors have to pay child support? Back in 2018, I was artificially inseminated because I'm a lesbian and I wanted kids, right? So me and my girlfriend decided that we were going to go find a donor and have a kid that way. When we broke up, she said that she had no legal obligation to this child and she didn't want to be the parent anymore.
Bye!
Of course, I was like, whatever, that's fine. Just give me, some child support. And she said, did you not hear me? I have no legal obligation to this child. I'm not going to pay child support.
This is crazy.
So now I'm trying to get the sperm donor to pay child support because biologically he is my daughter's parent. So I want him to give me his half. I don't know what to do at this point, but I just think it's really messed up that somebody can just go donate sperm and then have nothing else to do with the kid that comes from it.
Your kid don't have no dad and you don't got no top lip.
Bro.
This bitch look great. Look at her lip. She looked like one of the characters from Planet of the Apes.
Bro, bro. This is you see, regardless of the sexual orientation of a woman, bro, they all like literally sign up for shit, bro. Like, yeah. You literally signed up. Nobody like this was a stipulation on the contract.
Nobody told you to go over there.
The purpose. See, and I don't want to get too deep into this because I have personal shit of this situation in my family. How dare you? Because when two women or two men mm-hmm. decide they can't have babies.
Yeah.
So when they decide to adopt, it's for that reason. But that's not what it was created for originally. Sperm bank wasn't created for that. Right? It was created for a man and a woman who were attempting to have children and they couldn't because there's something either wrong with the man or the woman.
Mm-hmm.
So the adoption was the option created for them or for children who live in orphanage, whatever the case may be. It was never intended for people who can't have kids regardless. It was never intended for that.
I don't like that argument, though.
But that's a fact because we do know that LGBTQ is an alternative lifestyle.
Sure.
Alternative by definition means alternative to the norm.
But a lot of things are created and not used for their intended use. Like there was shit that happened during white colonial times that black people are not intended to use. And we
that's
use
fine.
Them.
But we do know that men and women only exclusively can make babies.
Right.
Right. Okay. So you had a luxury afforded to you because of something that's in the normal realm and you and your spouse wanted to go adopt a kid.
Yeah.
Right? Already, you're already setting this kid up to say, hey, you're not going to have a father.
Mm-hmm.
So if you and a girl would have worked out, you're raising a fatherless child. You purposely did that. Neither one of you can play the role of a father.
But there have been...
And now y'all split up and now you want the...
But there have been plenty of successful lesbian couples.
No, I'm not saying
it's
unsuccessful. I've never said that.
Okay.
I just said that you're not going to have a father. It's not an option.
Right.
Having a father, having a male figure.
This chick is crazy.
Right.
This chick is 100% crazy because now you out here looking for some random mystery nigga that didn't even know.
That is insane. And bro, she literally signed a contract stipulating that.
What you sound like is you're broke and you trying to look for a check or a handout
from
a nigga.
That's the delusion.
The delusion.
That's the delusion and what's the word I'm looking for?
Lack of accountability?
Yes. That's the space we end up with a lot of women, bro. It's like, shorty, did you just... And say it with a straight face then double down.
In black and white, too, so it's
bro,
extra traumatic.
Put music in the background and
Sarah
all that.
Sarah McLachlan playing
this
shit.
This bitch crazy as hell, son.
Hey, and she gonna get it, too. There's gonna be some court in somewhere in California like, yeah, no, I get it. You're white. It makes sense.
Bro, we gonna end this off on some funny shit, son. I saw this video, bro, and I thought this was a parody, son. So apparently this dude, he decided to steal somebody's package. I guess it was Amazon or whatever.
Hey, yo, pause.
Nigga pausing the wrong thing. But check this out. Look what he did.
This morning, a porch pirate used a trash bag, of all things, as a disguise.
Talk about make it work. Doorbell camera footage shows the person crouched underneath the
car. This is some cartoon shit, son.
Yeah, this is crazy.
Approaches the front door of a home in Sacramento, California, and swipes the package under the disguise and shuffles away.
No one's going to notice.
This thing is like Cousin It with a garbage bag.
What you're doing with your life, bro, you need to come.
Let me tell you something, son. If I came out the crib and I saw a nigga doing that, first of all, you can have it, bro. You've earned it.
You got it.
You've earned it.
You got it. It's a pack of clippers. It's a strainer. It's a spaghetti strainer.
Son, I remember a dude stole my shit from front of my house, right?
Mm-hmm.
First of all, it was dog food, bro.
Yeah.
Dry dog food.
You got it.
A 5-pound, no, no, I'm lying, a 20-pound bag of dry dog food, bro.
You got it.
What did you think that was? Bro, it was the heaviest bag known to man, son. Come on, son. Niggas is tripping. All right. So listen, what time is it? Okay, we good. So Kevin Deane, he's the new co-host, but we are actively seeking female co-hosts for the show. You know, I even feel weird saying female.
Yeah, apparently they don't like that.
But since when, though?
I hate calling the females females, but the females love it.
A lady, a woman. It's the only thing that sounds grammatically correct.
Do you know why they say they don't like that?
Why?
They're saying that female is a genetic term for animal. It's the female is the woman of any animal species.
So what are we?
And they say that we as men don't refer to each other as males. You're being derogatory towards women, and you're putting them at their most animalistic form.
But they call us males.
I don't really know that many women who refer to niggas.
Okay, watch this. So you saw the context I used in it. I said we're looking for a female co-host. Yeah. What word would I use in place of that?
We're looking for a woman co-host.
That don't sound right.
I mean,
but doesn't that sound?
That's preference. You. I also still say female, but I try to make
and I don't say girl because I'm not looking for a girl.
A little kid, right?
Right. So it's the only word that sounds grammatically correct to me. That's why I'm using it.
I don't think that you have any ill intentions behind it. I try not to say female because I know certain women don't like it.
You heard me say I feel weird saying it.
Yeah.
Right? Because I know how, but you know what though?
They're making it malicious and it's not.
But watch this though. Here's what we got to stop doing. And I do it on my page, but I do it for entertainment purposes. I pay more attention to the negative comments than the positive.
Yeah.
Obviously, it's way more positive. I get fucking millions of comments all the time, right? Yeah. However, I pay attention to the negative ones because those are the ones where I make additional content and roast them, right? Have you ever seen a transgender person complain about transgender rights?
No.
Right. It's always somebody else. I've never seen anybody of it's just like how I feel about like the whole Black Lives Matter shit.
Yeah.
I didn't really see no black people out there, bro. It's mostly white people.
It's a lot of white people that are trying to abstain for their white guilt.
It's, right.
And but that is, I don't want to put this on women because I don't want this to be this like women-hating podcast.
I don't think most women care about female, bro.
I think
I've never heard a woman I know, and I know a lot of women.
I've seen it in the comments on Facebook. That's the only reason that I know a little bit about this. But I think there's a whole generation of women that don't have an identity and don't have a hobby. So their hobby and identity is defending the victims of the world. They feel like, I gotta save the world. I gotta save the whales. Don't make fun of him. He's fat. He's sensitive. Don't make fun of them. They're gay. They're black. They're whatever. And it's like, what you're doing, you think that you're being heroic, but what you're doing is searching for an identity. Right. You're looking for a cause.
Right.
Because you don't have, you're boring. You're boring as shit. Pick up knitting. Play soccer. Do something. You're looking for an identity.
And also, you're an incel.
Yeah. They don't tell females that they're incel. They only tell niggas that they're.
You know what's crazy? You know what's so dope about men?
This is about to sound great or gay.
Male incels are cool with it.
Mm-hmm.
They're so cool with it that they've created a group and they've owned it.
And they just get together with themselves. They're out of the way.
They know women don't want them.
Yep.
For ladies, I've heard ladies have used that term on me before.
They call you an incel?
How? Intel literally means involuntarily celibate. That means nobody wants to fuck you.
Yeah.
Cap.
I feel like women's default arguments, they're either going to say that or they're going to say gay.
Always, yeah, you're bro. Gay. Always, because
you don't like women. I love women.
It's always that, bro.
Yeah.
I got 5 sisters and 4 daughters. Mm-hmm. How could I not love women? I didn't even grow up with a dad. Yeah. How could I not love women? I don't like you, bitch. Yeah.
There's certain things about society that I'm going to critique, but that doesn't mean that I don't like women. I'm going to have a louder voice and a louder opinions about this because I don't date men. I don't know the problems with men. That's what I'm listening to y'all.
Bro, you know what that's the equivalent of? That's the equivalent of when black people jump in my comment section and say, yo, we're talking about black people. Why you got... I'm like, because I'm black.
I stay out of white people's business. I don't
100%.
Know. 100%. I don't know white people's
shit. Why are you talking about black actors and black celebrities? Because I'm black. That's who I watch.
That's my culture.
That's it. Like, I don't get that. Like, who else am I? So, but if I wasn't talking about race, y'all call me racist when I'm talking about white people.
Yeah.
You're racist. You're racist now.
Everybody want to tell you what you are when they feel triggered, and they only want to say that when they're talking to their group or a group that they identify
with. It's always that.
Yeah, there are problems with women, and women don't want to have the conversation. And the big problem that I have with women is that when you start having these conversations that could advance us as a society, all they do is point the mirror back at you and be like, oh, yeah, well, men do that too, or men are bad too. there's no advancement then. So we can't have a conversation.
And it's disgusting work.
What you need to do is get yourself your podcast, debate the problems that we have, and then we come together as a collective and share notes.
That's why there are no successful female podcasts that don't talk about relationships. It can't do it.
Your world is around men.
Everything. Lady, and the minute y'all get to accept that, we'll be a better place. Like it's not saying that we're above you.
No.
We're just more entertaining than you.
You guys are great. You're nurturers. You're lovers. Your emotions are so complex and beautiful. But the problem is you're boring as shit. You don't have no entertainment value. Anytime you want to go do something fun, you're going to hit a nigga up or you're going to hit your girls up and talk about niggas.
Or go somewhere where men niggas are present.
Where men
because
are.
We can go to a fucking football game with 100,000 people in the stands and not a single one of them is a woman and we're going to have a great time.
Yep.
And ain't no gay shit going on.
Right.
We don't even give a fuck about the cheerleaders down there.
Niggas will get together and rap together. Niggas, yo, some of my boys, their favorite time of the week is when they can get together and play ball.
Bro, once you know what's crazy?
Week, just play ball.
You know what's crazy? We can have a great time. Like, yo, bro, women don't even understand what busy is.
Yeah. Right?
My busy is this.
Yeah.
I'm busy. I'm in my thoughts. I'm
chilling.
I'm chilling. That's busy. So what happens is you say you're busy and they feel like, oh, no, well, let's go do something. We don't need to do anything. Men are minimalists. We become. Listen, I saw this study. Sorry.
No, you.
I saw this study a couple of years ago and it said that not even this year. Single women are outpacing men with buying houses.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, it doesn't mean you have more money or you're more successful, shorty. It just means that you're preparing to take care of a nigga or you're preparing to be a single mom or you're preparing to move a man in. At the end of the day, we got a lot of money. You know what I'm saying? We don't mind living in a one-bedroom apartment. Mm-hmm. Who the fuck we need a house for?
They say it like this. Women are looking for comfort and security.
Right.
So a lot of those market tag items like a house, a car, all of those things are all things that men will have, but they're doing it to attract women.
Right.
All men really want is just a beautiful girl that they can show off to their friends.
We don't get girl. These things until we get a woman.
Right.
Right. The house is for the family. The minivan or the big truck is for the family. We don't need all of these things. Men will be just fine with an air mattress, a TV, and a PS5,
until
bro.
A woman criticizes us, and then now we feel like we got
to
do more.
Right. Everything's for women, bro.
Yeah.
Bro, listen. I got muscles and started going to the gym because my ex-girl
said something.
Liked arms.
Yeah.
I like his arms. Word.
Yeah.
And then I fell in love with it. And then now it's mine. Like, yeah. Like, working out is my thing.
Women bro. Will make you better. Women will evolve you.
Oh, for sure.
You.
But you know what's crazy? One woman will make you better.
Yeah.
Not a group. You don't need a group. You don't need the peanut gallery. Because women are like, fuck these bitches. Yeah. But the one woman. Because at the end of the day, and I mean big women up, anytime men fall on a hard time, it's always a woman that comes to your rescue. If you get locked up, it's a woman bailing you out for the most part. If you need a place to stay,
your
it's
niggas
a woman
won't be there for you.
Hell no.
Niggas are not nurturing. Men are not nurturing in general. So they're not going to be there
not
for you.
Nurturing unconditionally. Like it's not a continuous thing. It's like
no way.
Your boy might give you a hug if you're going through something, but yeah. Then it's like, nigga, shut up. Like
he gonna check on you the first week and be like, yo, you good? Snap out of it. Pull yourself out of it.
That's
if
it.
It's 7 days or more, you can't even be depressed around your male friends.
Here's why. Which is also why we don't want to hear women's problems, right? Because men are problem solvers.
Yeah.
Women women hoard problems. They complain a lot. Like if a chick is like, boom, if I'm going through something and I call you up, you probably like, yo, what you doing right now? Yo, come through and get a drink. You're trying to solve my problem.
Yeah.
You're not trying to hear it. You're trying to take me away from my problem.
Yeah, let's assess
a woman is gonna hug you and say, come here. You ever had a woman try to make you cry?
Yeah.
Like, come here. Because
it your does mom, something to them.
Right, because watch this. Like, even your mom does that. Like, I could be perfectly fine about, like, a kid could fall and hurt themselves, mm-hmm. and they'll be fine. But the minute they mom be like, come here, mm-hmm. then the kids start crying, right? Because women have a way of bringing emotions out of you.
Yeah.
And grown women do that, too. Like,
yeah.
come here. I'm like, no, fucking, I'm not trying to be emotional. I'm trying to get over this shit.
Yeah. I had a girl that we didn't get close. We didn't have, like, a true moment of intimacy until the first time she seen me cry. She was like, this is the only time I've ever seen you be vulnerable. I didn't even consider you a real person.
What she was crying about?
I don't even know. I was crying about our relationship, about me and her.
How old were you?
It's probably 31. I was probably like, but no, I'm talking like, I'm not talking like crocodile tears, and I'm not copping. Please, no, I was crying, but I was crying, but I'm at the point I'm crying out of frustration. I'm like, yo, I'm sick.
I'm glad I got. Listen, let me say something. I'm glad I got all my bitch assness out of my system very young.
Is crying bitch ass?
What? All right. Okay.
Are niggas not allowed to be vulnerable?
What was the status of your relationship?
We were together. I wasn't crying over her like, oh, take me back type shit. I'm crying like, yo, I'm mad fucking frustrated with this situation.
That's fine. Crying out of frustration is fine because here's the thing. You probably didn't realize that women operate off emotion. We operate off logic.
Yeah.
And that's the thing for me too. I think you're a brain like I'm a brain.
Yeah.
Right? So I get very frustrated when people insult my intelligence.
Oh,
me I don't
too.
Even give a fuck about a lie. I give a fuck about what you try to convince me to believe.
Yeah.
Right? I don't care about you lying to me. Like, the lie don't bother me. People lie all the time to get these stuff. Like, if you're lying to get yourself out of a jam,
yeah,
cool. But if you're trying to convince me to believe you,
yeah,
like, you think I'm a believe?
You want me to indulge in your delusion.
Right, because
and you think I'm stupid.
Right, because here's the thing, right? Certain times, it's better to tell a lie than the truth. Yeah. That's what a lot of women don't realize either, right? Because there's shit that happened in my life where it looked like I was lying and I wasn't. Like, boom. At the club one night, I see a girl I know. I give her a hug. Wind up with makeup on the shirt. First strike of the night. Then my phone dies.
Yep.
Right?
So oh, when, you look like you've also, been in a wild
when, also, when she hugged me, her perfume got on me.
Mm-hmm.
Then I'm on my way home, flat tire. Right?
Oh, yeah.
Then my jack don't work for my car. Right? So now I'm out there for an extended period of time. So now I finally changed the tire. I walk in the house 6 o'clock in the morning, phone dead, no charge in the car, smelling like perfume, with makeup on my shirt. What did it look like?
It looked like you've been out fucking.
Regardless of what I say,
right.
It looked like a lie. So sometimes you got to lie because.
What do you just, you double down? You just be like, yeah, I was out fucking?
No, and it's either, it's something she could never confirm or deny or believe it. It's nothing she can do about it. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes I've told the truth. Right? Jokingly. And that's what one of our perks is as a comedian.
Yeah.
What you was doing, baby? Oh, no, I just finished fucking two bitches. Oh, my God. They was bad. Yo, why I nutted in one face? That shit was crazy. You're so stupid. Nigga, I really was doing that shit.
Nigga, that's a go-to of mine, nigga.
Really?
The straight face lie? The straight face joking
bro,
lie?
Bro, listen, that's the beauty of being a comedian. So, like, I will, like, look a woman dead in her face and be like, nah, we can't give her too much.
Who are you texting right now, baby? I'm like, come on, I'm just talking about my other girl. Why are you always stressing me? She's like, oh, baby, you
really?
So, you play
and,
so much.
And really right now, you got titties all in your phone.
Yeah, I'm like.
All types of shit. That shit is crazy.
She's like, yo, why you got to get up every time you get a Snapchat? I'm like, oh, you know, these hoes be snapping me crazy pictures.
You still on Snapchat?
Oh, yeah, no, it's nasty. It's crazy. How could you ever get away from that?
Bro.
The titties is never ending.
Anyway, nigga, I got a show to do tonight. And you probably got a book tonight, too.
Yeah.
Well, listen, I don't know what the fuck happened to my son. He got up out of here.
this nigga got out of Dodge. He was like, yo, they talking about trans shit on the podcast. I got to go.
But listen, over the next couple of weeks, you guys are going to see us scouting for a woman,
yes.
Lady.
Look at you growing, dog. I'm so impressed. Yeah. I'm so proud of you.
Co-host.
Yes.
Because I think the estrogen will balance us out.
It's a nice touch. I'm looking for a woman who's going to offer some pushback and
right. And not be, because I think we're both very opinionated and we speak well. And I think having that, also eye candy, right? Mm. I said pretty chicks, and no offense to a lot of y'all who hit me up. Come on.
Come on.
Your DMs ain't blowing up. Nobody your DMs.
Well, that's not a good gauge anyway, because their DMs can be blowing up and you might not be bad. Niggas will gas a 5 up because they know they could bag
the 5.
We
just went through this. We just went through this.
Yeah.
But no, being pretty also isn't, like, that's not the end all be all. Because I've had plenty of pretty chicks on my show and they didn't offer any. And then we talked about this earlier, like, the problem with a lot of women is when they're sitting around a strong, opinionated man, they will abandon their campaign with their opinion.
They'll buckle.
Yeah, because, oh, wow, he said it way better than me, so I agree with him.
Yeah.
But be strong enough to stand on your two, but also be strong enough to not get offended by it and get confrontational.
Right.
That's nasty.
We're just looking to have conversations. And that's I want to hear from you. I don't want to hear from me through your mouth.
Right. Also, I am who I am. Kev is who he is. And whoever she is will be that, because I believe a woman brings balance to everything.
Yeah.
Right. I know we went in on women. It may seem that way. But listen, there's nothing more powerful and stronger than a woman. Nothing. And y'all need to know that about yourselves. That's why there's been no female president yet. Because y'all don't even know that about yourselves.
Yeah, y'all got to start believing in yourself. I love my sisters, yo. Shout out to all the black queens out there watching and listening to the podcast.
Big facts. Big facts.
I'm dating Puerto Ricans, but shout out to the black ones.
Big facts. But listen, yo, this is episode 206. Show was amazing. I'd like to welcome my brother Kevin Deane to the show. I'm glad to have him here. And all jokes aside, is here to stay, y'all. So, shout out to my boy Fredo Cash, writer, producer, author, all that good shit of the All Jokes Aside theme song. Let's get it. Whoa. Fredo. Love it. He'll learn the theme song soon enough, y'all.
Me and Pyrex together.
Watch your words to lie.
Me and Jackie bought out the sweets when we got hella whores inside. Whoa.
I'm the shit, I'm the shit. Bitch, all jokes aside.
I'm the shit, I'm the shit. Bitch, all jokes aside.
Till next week, y'all. See y'all same time, same blood clot place. Peace.